So moving on to our next story, we are talking about Ultraman R&B, or RB. I don't know actually how it's pronounced. I've been pronouncing it like the genre of music, or it could be pronounced like Arby's. But what I do know is that this show has been announced for North American Blu-ray release. So let me put on my glasses to read the article itself. Now, I do believe I might have mentioned this either in an Ultraman Z press conference on Toku Station or for a review of one of the two Ultraman Z episodes that I've reviewed so far. More on the way, of course, because it's more that have been released on Tsuburaya's YouTube channel. But what's interesting is that when I was talking about it, I was like, you know, it would be nice if they end up putting out R&B in the near future, because of the fact that I'm pretty sure this show, and correct me if I'm wrong, everyone, this show was simulcast on their YouTube channel, just like Zet was. And obviously them not talking about releasing it might make some people go, oh no, if I don't watch it on the YouTube channel, how long is it really going to take for this show to even come out? And this show, by the way, initially had come out in 2018. I want to make sure I have the exact date. I do know that it was in 2018, however. And so it is interesting now that we're getting it and the movie, by the way, on Blu-ray. Yes, this show initially had come out July 7th, 2018, and it ended December 22nd, 2018, with only 25 episodes. So, talking about the fact that, yes, on Blu-ray, they're releasing the original series, 25 episodes, as well as the film, which is the Ultraman R&B, the movie Select the Crystal of Bond. Okay. So either way, we don't know too much other than the fact that it says more details to come next week, including pre-order options. However, though, there must have been some edit to the article, because we do know that the Ultraman R&B bundle will be released October 13th, 2020, and that the current listed MSRP is $50. Now, initially, a lot of the series were much, much cheaper, other than Ultraman Ginga and Ultraman Ginga S, but that is technically two series and its movie, so I understood it's extra priced. Now, in this case, I wonder if it's $50 because of the fact that it's not available on any other streaming service as far as I know. So please correct me if I'm wrong in the comment section down below, but as far as I know, this is not available anywhere else. So Tsuburaya and Mill Creek look at this and they think, well, it isn't available anywhere else compared to, again, some other shows that they've put out in the past, like Ultraman Orb, I believe Ultraman Geed as well, and some other Ultraman series that I do believe have been on other streaming services in the past. I mean, of course, the original three have been released other times as well. So you look at those and you think, yeah, let's have those be 27 or so, at least from Amazon where I had purchased them. But when you have something like Ultraman R&B, you think, you know, let's put it at 50. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if maybe when it's released on Amazon, maybe it'll be a little bit cheaper. Maybe it'll be 38 or 40 or something like that. But I would not be surprised if this stays relatively close to that $50 mark, because I'm pretty sure if we quickly look up Ultraman Ginga and Ginga S, I'm pretty sure it's actually 50 there. So Ginga S, let's see, Ultraman Ginga Ginga S. Oh no, it's actually $28 on Amazon. That's interesting. So then this actually might end up being $28 there as well, because it says that the MSRP is 50 for this. Huh, that's interesting. So that's something that should definitely be talked about. Damn, I knew that the other ones were more expensive before they were ended up on Amazon as well, but man, that Ultraman Ginga Ginga S being 28 instead of 50. Huh, should I buy that right now on the spot? I don't know. I'm contemplating it, I'll tell you that much. But either way, let's move back to our story and talk about the fact that, again, this is coming out October 13th. I would suggest getting it. I mean, again, I know it's shorter than some other Ultraman series out there for the price that it's at, but it's one of the newer ones. So coming out in 2018, I think that's very interesting as well. It shows that because I thought coming out with Orb and Geed showed that they had no problem going, you know, to newer Ultraman, but going to R&B really does show you that you really have to set your expectations higher than you may have initially thought, because I thought they were going to stick with the Showa era, then they end up coming to shows from the 2010s, and now all of a sudden we're jumping back and forth in a beautiful way. So I definitely, and even going for some more obscure stuff, I mentioned so at least I consider it obscure, some Ultra Q related stuff that I talked about an episode or two back. So yeah, this was announced on Ultraman Day, like I said with our last story. Happy Ultraman Day. I know you didn't get me anything, that's just fine. I didn't get you anything, so we're even, we're ultra even actually. And this is going to be a lot of fun, so I may end up picking this up sometime in the future. Again, I don't believe we have this listed on Amazon as of right Now I'm going to check right now. Accidentally closed that window. That's awful. Great thing to do as we're recording this. Yes, it is not available through... the Switch game is available, but remember, though, it's in Japanese. And I think it was more of a mini game type dealy. Yeah, it's available through Amazon. You can get it, but I'm pretty sure it was... Yeah, it's mostly text-heavy, and it's in Japanese. Unlike some... That would be a fun thing to look at next. I'm just saying. I know you have to talk to Bandai Namco about that, but... just saying, I mean, we have some Kamen Rider games released in other parts of the world, and they have English subtitles, yet this doesn't. I'm just saying it would be nice, you know. But on a serious note, tell me what you think down below. Are you interested in this? Are you not interested? Is it now on your huge want list from Mill Creek? Or are you thinking, it was okay? So either way, tell me your thoughts down in the comment section down below.